Hello my dear students, in this lecture we are going to see one previous year GATE numerical. This question was asked in GATE 2014 for 2 marks in set 2. The question is basically based on conduction topic, and again in conduction the question is based on heat transfer through a composite slab. So let us understand the question. The question is, a material P of thickness 1 mm is sandwiched between two steel slabs as shown in figure below. Now here you can see there is a one steel slab on the left side, there is another steel slab on the right side, and between these two steel slabs material P with thermal conductivity K is sandwiched. Right. A heat flux 10 watt per meter square is supplied to one end of the steel slab as shown. Now you can see here the heat flux is given to the left end of the slab. Therefore, here the heat flux Q is given. Q is nothing but heat transfer per unit area, which is called heat flux. It is given 10 kilowatt per meter square. Here you can find in the given data. Again, it can be written as this heat flux will be equal to 10 into 10 to the power 3 watt per meter square. Right, this much heat flux is provided over here. Then the boundary temperatures of the slab are indicated in the figure. Now here in the figure you can find the boundary temperature. Here left end temperature is 500 degrees Celsius. Here they have mentioned this temperature is 500 degrees Celsius and right end temperature is 360 degrees Celsius. Right. Then assume thermal conductivity of steel is 10 watt per meter Kelvin. Now for this steel, the thermal conductivity is given K. So let us assume, here I am assuming this left side steel slab is first, this in between there is a second slab which is P, and the right side steel slab is 3, right? And the thermal conductivity K1 and K3 is given. K1 and K3 are the thermal conductivities of steel slab. Therefore here we can say K1 is equal to K3 is equal to 10 watt per meter Kelvin. This data they have provided in the question, right? Then consider one dimensional steady state heat conduction. Now here we have to assume 1D, one directional means along x direction only there will be heat flow. Steady state, right, means the temperature will not change with respect to time. That means the temperature of the walls will be same and the heat transfer rate or this heat flux flowing through the slab will be same at each and every location or through each and every slab. Now heat conduction for the configuration, the thermal conductivity K in watt per meter Kelvin of the material P is. Now what will be the thermal conductivity of this material P? Here it is given in the question. Right, this K we have to find for the material P. Now my dear students, as heat is flowing through this circuit, so this first slab will be offering some resistance, second slab will offer some resistance, and third slab also offers some resistance for the heat transfer. And through the slab, the resistance offered for the heat transfer will be equal to B divided by Ka. This formula we have derived, right? Where B is the thickness of slab. For first slab it is 20 mm, for second slab it is 1 mm, and for third slab it is again 20 mm. K is the thermal conductivity of individual slab, and A is the area perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. Now for each and every slab, the perpendicular area is same here. You can observe this will be the perpendicular area for the direction of heat flow. For all slabs, this will be the area only. Right. So my dear students, here area will be constant. And if I draw circuit, right, between temperature T1 and let us say this interface temperatures. Let us say if I assume here, at this end, let us say temperature is some T dash, and at this phase, let us say I am assuming T3 and T4. Here, let us say T3 and here T4. Right. Now, heat is flowing from T1 to T3, then T3 to T4, and then from T4 to T2. Now, between T1 and T3, the resistance will be R1. Therefore, here we can say if I draw circuit between temperature here T1. And T3, the resistance will be R1, which will be equal to B1 divided by K1A. Between T3 and T4, again there will be one more resistance. Between T3 and T4, there will be a resistance of this slab P, which will be again B2 divided by, this will be the R2. This resistance will be R2, which will be B2 divided by K2A. And between T3 and T4, it is a resistance. Right, it is a T4. Do a correction. between T3 and T4, this will be the resistance. And between T4 and T2, there will be another resistance. That is, between T4 and T2, there will be RC, which will be equal to B3 divided by K3A. Right. So, my dear students, this will be the circuit, and through this circuit, the heat is flowing. Here, the heat is flowing. Through this circuit, the heat is flowing steadily. And my dear students, this heat transfer through the circuit is nothing but delta T, change in temperature divided by resistance. If I write T1 minus T3, then I have to write resistance between T1 and T3, which is R1. If I write T3 minus T4, then I have to write resistance between T3 and T4, which is R2. If I write here T4 minus T2, then I have to write resistance between T4 and T2, which is R3. And my dear students, as they have provided temperature of left extreme end and right extreme end, so if I write T1 minus T3, right, if I write T1 minus T3, sorry, T2, T1 minus T2, between T1 and T2, all the resistance, that is R1, R2 and R3, will come in series, therefore they will get added. Therefore, R1 plus R2 plus R3, this is how we have to write. And my dear students, this last relation we are going to use, that is heat is equal to, this heat transfer is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. So let us equate them. Therefore, here we can say this Q will be equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Right. So let us put the values of all resistance. Right. Here we are going to put the values of resistance. Right. So let us substitute the values of resistance over here. Therefore, we can say this Q will be equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1 is B1 divided by K1A plus R2 is B2 divided by K2A plus R3 is B3 divided by K3A. Now, my dear students, from both sides, if I consider area common, right, or divide by area, divide this side by area, then I will get Q by A, which is nothing but heat flux. Therefore, Q by A, which is nothing but heat flux, will be, therefore, from this side, area will get cancelled. Therefore, it will become T1 minus T2 divided by B1 by K1 plus B2 by K2 plus B3 divided by K3. This is how we will get the result. Now, my dear students, let us put the values. Here, B1 is 20 mm, which is nothing but 20 into 10 to the power minus 3. Mm, if I want to convert into meter, this B1 will become 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. B2 will become, here B2 is given 1 mm. Therefore, it will be 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. And B3 is 20 mm, which is nothing but B1. Therefore, B3 is equal to, B1 is equal to 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Let us put these values. K1 and K3 are the thermal conductivity of steel slab, which is given 10. Right. Here, Q is given 10 into 10 to the power 3 watt per meter square. Right. Then T1 and T2 are given 500 and 360. Here these temperatures are given 500 and 360 Kelvin. Right. If I put all these values, let us solve for the here K2. So my dear students, here Q is 10 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to T1 is 500 minus T2 is 360 divided by B1 is 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by K1 is 10 plus B2 is 1 into 10 to the power minus 3, K2 is thermal conductivity of material P, which is K, plus, now here B3 is again 20 into 10 to the power minus 3, 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by K3 is 10. Right. So my dear students, if I equate this equation, here in this equation only K is unknown. Now my dear students, here there is a only school level mathematics. You have to solve for this K, thermal conductivity K. Right. Let us simplify this equation and solve this school level mathematics. Then you will find this K will be equal to 0.1 watt per meter Kelvin. Right. So my dear students, here in this fill in the blanks, they are asking in watt per meter Kelvin. So as they are asking in watt per meter Kelvin, you have to type 0.1 only here. Right. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on this topic, which was asked in previous year GATE examination.